India is expected to become the fourth largest spender on travel in the world. Luxury car sales in India hit a record high in 2023. और जितना हम इंडियन शादी पे खर्चा करते हैं उतनी तो कंट्रीज की GDP भी नहीं होती. इन सब से एक बात तो क्लियर है, इंडियंस आर विलिंग टू स्प्लॉज. बट ये क्यों हो रहा है? Watch this video to find out. Hey, I'm Janvi and welcome to Charcha Jari Hai. By 2027, 10 crore Indians are going to be moving into the affluent category, as in those who earn about 8.3 lakhs annually. By 2028, there'll be roughly 20,000 ultra high net worth individuals. Matlab those who have a net worth of 250 crores. India seems to be moving up the income ladder. Back in the 90s, India ranked 17th in terms of GDP. Today it ranks about 5th, and by 2030 it's expected to rank about 3rd. So what exactly happens when incomes start rising? Let's rewind to the US in the 1950s. World War II had just ended and helped lift the economy out of the Great Depression. Jobs were plenty, wages were higher, and because of the lack of consumer goods during the war, Americans were really, really eager to spend, and thus started the era of consumerism. Aisa kuch India mein bhi ho raha hai. People have a lot of disposable income and don't mind spending on themselves. When a country sees such a shift, the first thing we see is the rise in discretionary consumption. This means the consumption of non-essential goods such as clothes, gadgets or experiences. Take a look at this trend of MPCE, yani monthly per capita consumption expenditure.
पिछले 20 साल में हमारा स्पेंडिंग पैटर्न फ्लिप हो गया है. फूड एज अ परसेंटेज ऑफ मंथली एक्सपेंडिचर इज गोइंग डाउन, व्हाइल परसेंटेज ऑफ फैशन एंड एंटरटेनमेंट इज गोइंग अप.
दिस डजंट मीन दैट वी आर ईटिंग लेस, इट्स जस्ट अबाउट अपग्रेडिंग आवर लाइफस्टाइल. इट्स नॉट जस्ट डिस्क्रेशनरी कंजम्पशन, इट्स प्रीमियम डिस्क्रेशनरी कंजम्पशन दैट्स गोइंग अप. जस्ट टेक अ लुक एट दिस चार्ट. Mass brands like V-Mart, HUL, Hero MotoCorp and Mahindra & Mahindra grew less rapidly than their premium counterparts. In fact, luxury car sales hit a record high in 2023, growing 20% year on year. Indians are clearly willing to go for expensive brands. Italian luxury brand Bulgari launched a Kara bracelet exclusively for India. This wasn't a first, we've seen many such iterations before. Bulgari's Mangalsutra, LV's Rani Pink footwear and Dior's mesmerizing show at the Gateway of India. Bulgari's CEO said, India is among our top 10 markets, but soon it'll be number 3. There's a lot of appetite for high jewelry here. We just need more luxury malls to set up shop. Speaking of luxury malls, India's largest luxury mall, Jio World Plaza, just opened its stores last year. और जियो की बात करें तो आनंद अंबानी की शादी सबने सोशल मीडिया पे देखी होगी. द वेडिंग बिजनेस इज ऑफ द चार्ट्स एंड दिस शादी सीजन विच इज जैन टू जुलाई 24, वी आर एक्सपेक्टिंग टू सी 42 लाख वेडिंग्स विच विल जेनरेट बिजनेस वर्थ 5.5 लाख करोड़ रुपीज. लेट दैट सिंक इन. बस इतना ही नहीं, अब तो समर वेकेशंस चालू हो गए हैं एंड दैट मीन्स ट्रैवल. आवर स्पेंडिंग ऑन ट्रैवल एंड टूरिज्म इज एक्सपेक्टेड टू रीच $410 billion by 2030, making us the fourth largest spender on travel in the world. Here's something we'd want to leave you with though. India's rank in terms of GDP has surely jumped from 17th to 5th in the past 30 years. But our GDP per capita rank has barely budged. It's just moved from 161 to 159. As the age-old saying goes, the rich have gotten richer and the poor have gotten poorer.
India has been grappling with income inequality for a long time,
but it has only gotten worse since the pandemic. As per a study done by the World Inequality Lab, 22.6% of India's national income went to the top 1% of the population in FY23. This has been the highest proportion in the past 100 years. Why should this be concerning? An IMF study found an indirect relationship between how much the rich earn versus the country's economic growth. The study says that if the top 20% of the population earns even 1% more income, then for the following 5 years, the GDP growth for that country will be 0.8% lower. Can we afford that, or can we fix inequality? Only time will tell. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next episode of Charcha Jari Hai.